Workbench is IQ's desktop application where you can evaluate the amazing capabilities of our automatic image correction technology in real time. You can also use Workbench to tweak corrections and create your own custom presets. To get started, you can load in images by either dragging and dropping them or simply clicking here and selecting the images you want to test. Once your photos are loaded in, the corrections are applied automatically. To see the before picture, you can either press the space bar or left click once with your mouse. You can also switch to different views in the top left corner to see side-by-side images or to use the before and after slider. One of the most amazing things about our latest Workbench is that it includes our AI preset selection technology. This tech uses machine learning to detect image content and scenes, and then automatically applies a specific preset based on which scene is detected. So as I flip through photos on the right side under the AI sliders, you can see how the scene changes based on the contents of the image. So for photos of landscapes and sunsets, you can apply something more vibrant and colorful. And for photos of newborns or professional portraits, you can apply something more gentle and delicate. This technology is super powerful because it allows you to apply different presets to different kinds of images, and it all happens automatically. Now that all of your images are perfectly corrected, to save your images, simply press Save to save out the individual image you're on, or Save All to save out all the images that you've loaded into Workbench. When you press either of the save options, this window will pop up so that you can decide where and how you want your images saved. You can save your images in the folder of your choosing or even place them in a subfolder. In terms of naming your image, I find this first option particularly helpful because it adds perfectly clear to the end of the names of the edited images, which is nice if you're comparing before images later outside of Workbench. And then lastly, you can choose your file type and a couple of other file settings. That is it for our intro to Workbench. I hope that you enjoy testing it out for yourself. And if you're interested in learning how to create custom presets in Workbench, then be sure to tune in for the next video. Thanks so much.